Hi, I am Gabriela Barahona Caicedo. I'm going to talk about controlled trial of two incremental milk feeding rate in the preter infants. Definition. Observational data have shown that slow advancing of enteral feeding volumes in preter infants is associated with a reduced risk of necrosizing enterocolitis, but increased risk of late onset sepsis. However, data from randomized trial are limited. Now continue the video.
In their first weeks, babies who are born very early may need help breathing and have to be fed by intravenous drip. But as they progress, they will begin to take milk feeds, usually given by tube through the baby's mouth or nose. Breast milk is best, for many reasons. Preterm babies are especially vulnerable to illness and infection, and in particular, a serious gut infection, which can be fatal. Breast milk, unlike formula milk, contains protection against serious infections. And it has other important benefits. It's rich in special ingredients to help your baby grow and is easier for your baby's gut to absorb. Even if your baby isn't able to take breast milk straight away, it's important to start expressing your breast milk as early as you can, as it can be stored for your baby and will help your body build up a good supply.
Let's go continue application in nursing. When clinicians were ready to start advancing feeding volumes, infants were randomly assigned to receive daily increment in feeding volume of 30 millikilograms faster increment or 18 millimeters per kilogram slower increment. Computerizing randomization was performed through a security website helped by the Nationality Perinatal Epidemiology Unit Clinical Trial Unit University Oxford. Continue video. Okay, continue pros and cons. Pros: the primary outcome was survival with two moderate of developmental disability at 24 months of age, correct for the gestational age at birth. Cons: secondary outcomes include death before discharge hunt, microbiological confirmed of clinical suspect late onset sepsis from the trial entry to chain hunt. Continue video.
1 in 9 infants that are born prematurely, or around 12% of all births in the United States. Any time that you are born more than 4 weeks early from your due date, which is 40 weeks of time in the uterus, then you're defined as being born prematurely. The children that are at greatest risk for problems, including cerebral palsy or major learning difficulties, are those who are born very early, and that's more than 12 weeks before their due date. From current literature, we know that if you're born from 22 weeks, i.e. just over halfway through the pregnancy, you can survive. So many of these infants now survive, but unfortunately go on to face later challenges. So the most common adverse outcome of being born prematurely is suffering from problems in learning and leading to problems in schooling later in life. Around 50 to 60% of prematurely born children will have to repeat a grade by the time they reach middle school.
Now continue issue apply in Ecuador. Most participating infants were fed at least partially with breast milk. Only 2.8% of the infants who were followed to 24 months were fed formula alone, with similar numbers in the two groups. With respect to the formula-only infant, the fear of a poorer outcome in the faster increment growth than in the slow increment growth probably represents a change fear given the small number of infants. Substantial loss of follow-up and multiple comparison performance with tow at Hotman for multiple testing. The risk-benefit balance of enteral feeding strategies may differ between human meal feed infants and formula feed infants. Now the video. Let's go continue in my conclusion. In my conclusion, the speed of advancing enteral feeding volumes daily increment of 30 ml per kilogram as compared with 18 ml per kilogram did not have a significant effect on the primary outcome observable without moderate of several neurodevelopmental disabilities, nor did affect the risk of late onset sexism of recognizing in very preterm or very low birth weight infant. Finally, continue the video.
When you have a baby who's born prematurely, they're not capable of eating at the breast. So the pump becomes a surrogate for that act of breastfeeding.
Some moms never had any intention to breastfeed, and they've seen how hard their babies have fought to live. they realize that this is a gift.
I don't know if it was the smell or the taste, but you could see in their face, they just smiled and kind of perked up.
As for the NICU environment, we can do lots of things, but I cannot recreate the human body. That bond that the mom is able to provide and the milk that she provides is crucial for their development.
Yes, my baby is in the NICU, but I'm playing such a big part of his growing and his developing. It's amazing what the milk itself can do.
For my presentation.